Nick, tonight we've got a non-conference matchup.
Just because it's a non-conference matchup doesn't mean there's not a lot on the line. Mr. Nestler, I assure you, the selection committee pays close attention to these games.
There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
The starting five, these kids are the tone setters. Coach expects them to set the tone as soon as the ball is tossed up.
And the referee is ready to toss it up.
And the first half is underway, baby.
Gave it up. He makes the block.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Off the glass and no good. Running that Princeton offense here.
Hey, Brad, the Princeton offense is based on a lot of motion, movement without the basketball. You got to really be able to cut and go to the goal.
They look to get it to the inside. The Hoyas won their last contest, and now they're trying to make it two straight. Both teams looking to get things going here. And the strip, quick hand.
Oh, what a great job transition, offense. Poor job defensively. Don't get back, don't stop the ball. And they were allowed to convert, get the number game going.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nestler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. This team right now just lighting it up from everywhere.
Hey, they're fighting each other in rhythm with their passing, Brad. That makes a huge difference in how shooters shoot.
They work it around the perimeter.
Double team now, bad angle. And the fans love it, man. They love it. Our house, baby, our house.
Pulls up with a jumper. The missed shot. The center handles the pass. He bombs from outside. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
And we've got a pause in the action. More NCAA basketball coverage coming up right after this. Al and Brad Nestler with you here, ready for the inbound after that timeout.
There's the trap.
With a fadeaway jumper, look at that follow through.
Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
On the left side. He pump fakes. Out on the wing. Oh, yes. A great drive to the hoop right there, Dick.
You know, he did a great job putting the ball on the floor and getting to the basket.
Looks like you're going to drop into a 1-3-1 zone defense here. out on top, controlling the ball. He buries the shot. The Tigers now running a zone offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Off the glass and no good. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. On the outside. Jump hook from the low block. Nope. He gets the rebound. The Hoyas can't afford to have him pick up too many more fouls. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Dick, I think they're going to fall back into a 1-3-1 zone defense here.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from the corner. Man, Dick, they are making scoring here look impossible.
I tell you, horrific, awful, terrible, poor, appalling. I'm absolutely embarrassed, Brad.
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Cross court. And the block. Trying to penetrate that zone and the shot's blocked. Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. Six minutes left on the game clock. The small forward gets the pass. 10 to shoot now. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from outside and come up short. Trying to feed the low block in the lane. Can't connect. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Number 10 picks up the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
Hey, I tell you, juniors and seniors are valuable pieces in any college basketball puzzle. Having experienced kids like this on the court and on the bench can take a lot of pressure off the coaching staff.
Routine. They work the perimeter. Good fake. He shoots from the top of the circle.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
We're at the 5 minute mark.
Look at that spacing.
Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
Got the high pick.
Up it inside.
Oh, for the bucket. In and out. The shooting guard with the ball. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. Busts the J. A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
That's a bang-bang play, Brad. That's a great cut and an even better pass.
Moving it around the perimeter. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
They'll work it around the arc. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Buries it. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that, right, Dick?
Doing a wonderful job putting the ball on the floor and getting into the painted area.
Three minutes left on the game clock. He tries the jumper. Now with about 10 seconds to shoot. He gets that one to fall. Working it around the perimeter. For two, goes in. Now they work it around the perimeter. The crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Cross court. About 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Off them and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Looks like they're going with a 1-3-1 zone. The Tigers now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Brad. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
Hey, you know he's been excellent, Brad. He's been efficient. He's been focused. What a gritty performance. And giving his team a great chance to win.
So they'll inbound on the near sideline. It's a fast break possibility for the bucket. They are heating up this building with their shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
About a minute remaining in the game clock. On the outside. That blocked. Missed it. Shoots. Perfectly executed. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Jumper off the mark. Shot clock is dead. Mm-hmm. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. You're 15 to 17 feet apart.
At halftime, the Hoyas lead by 20. Georgetown is showing tremendous accuracy from the floor in the first half, partner.
They're so well coached, man. Working the ball around for the high percentage shot. That's a lot of maturity, man. They really are a mature basketball team.
Looks like they're going to go with a full-court man-to-man press, Dick. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Ten on the shot clock.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. Both teams are looking to get something going here. They're working around the perimeter. Tries for two. Out of bounds and a change in possession. Let's check out this jumper one more time. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover here.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
The shooting guard gets the ball. Around the perimeter. Ten on the shot clock. Number four takes the pass. Great trap. They managed to keep the defender in check.
What a great defensive trap there.
On the outside. Shot clock violation. Dick, they really put the clamps on them there.
Clamps is right, Brad. They ran, but they couldn't hide.
The dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Off the mark with that shot. There's a double team waiting there. Tickles a twine.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Takes the jumper. They got it. And a momentary look from three-point land. Two. Gets it to go. That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Dick?
I tell you, he's really attacking the goal. He's going in fearless, and he's absolutely attacking the defense.
Here they come with a double team to stop it. A little two-man action. Inside. And the slam. That's a momentum buster.
He's here to fight, baby.
Looking for a good shot. For the bucket. Makes it. They work the perimeter. Here's a double team. shot's blocked.
That shot's got to come quicker against the zone, Brad.
Here, I'm thinking it was a pretty quick shot the way it was, Dick.
Not quick enough, baby.
Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. He shoots from the deep corner. The missed shot. Number four is charged with the foul. First team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
And we get a look at the numbers so far this season, Dick.
One thing that stats don't show, Brad, are the intangibles. The pass that leads to the pass that ultimately leads to a score. Deflections, diving for loose balls. Those are all the important stats in my book.
He missed it.
Good rebound position. Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
They go into the low block. Oh, he dribbled the ball out of bounds. The Hoyas have come out here, and they're really focused on sharing the ball and really playing pretty good defense.
You can't have any weak links out there at this level. The coaches and players are just too good, and they'll be exposed. So far, it's been a demonstration of teamwork here today. Up and inside!
Goes up with a shot. And come up short. 7 minutes left on the game clock. And it's dripped. Active hands. Looks like you're going to drop into a 1-3-1 zone defense here. Looking for a good shot. Number one with the foul. First personal foul. Now let's check back in now on our Star Watch player. Turnover. They run it up into transition. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Goes up for two. They just can't seem to get a nice look at the goal tonight.
They have to be patient on offense and find some easy hoops.
They get it to go. We're at the 6 minute mark. The student body is rocking tonight.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
Moving it around the perimeter. Here they come now on a turnover. For two. Off the glass and no good. He does the sweet fake shot for the bucket. Doesn't go. Number 42 receives the pass. Falling back into a man-to-man defense, Dick. Number 20 gets the pass. Buries it home. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. Fans will be celebrating tonight, Dick. This one's out of reach.
Well, it's simple. They came out, executed a game plan, and ended up on top.
They're working around the arc. Tries for two. Nice shot. around the perimeter. He's too important to this team to be picking up fouls like that. Looks like they're going to drop into a man-to-man defense now. About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. The point guard gets the ball. That's an ill-advised shot.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
On the outside. Shoots from outside. Busts the jumper. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that, right, Dick?
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. And some great concentration to finish strong.
Drains it. He puts up the J. Jumper won't go. Drains the shot. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
Gave it up.
Nice hops.
Two minutes left on the game clock. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Puts up the jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Sinks the shot. Around the perimeter. Three. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. From the corner. Off the mark. Goes up for two. There was no doubt about that one. 1 minute left on the game clock. They work it around the perimeter. Looks like they're going to drop into a 1-3-1 zone defense here. He tries to knock down the three.
A great shot block right there. Yeah, some good movement on the offensive side.
Dick, can they have it? He blocks the shot. Number one, they spent right now emotionally. Dick.
Yeah, it's unfortunate to see this, Brad. I feel for him.
We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more ESPN coverage of the NCAA. The Tigers trail as we head into this timeout. More basketball coverage coming up. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. He just can't escape the pressure.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
Missed the jumper. Dick, they just can't get the shot over the zone.
It's a great execution on D.
Swatted away. Out of bounds, and we're staying right here.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
Number 31 takes the feed. They work it around the perimeter. He attempts a jump shot. Can't connect. Cross court. He shoots from the corner. Missed it. Where I'm from, that's called back-to-back wins, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, Brad, they seem as though they've turned the corner and have figured out what winning basketball is all about.
Georgetown wins in an absolutely humiliating blowout.
Well, they came into favorites, and they did not disappoint.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.